Hello everybody, my name is Jack and welcome back for a special episode of Visiting Italy. Today we will visit Medici Riccardi Palace, located in Florence. If you loved, like I did, the Medici Masters of Florence TV series, you will absolutely fall in love with this beautiful building in which the first season of the TV series was shot, alongside numerous sets scattered around Tuscany and created in theatrical sets. Amazing! Reaching the palace, it is absolutely easy. You can start from the Cathedral of Santa Maria del Fiore and it only takes 3 minutes by foot to reach the palace. Although you can use the train station Firenze Santa Maria Novella as a starting point, from there only 10 minutes by foot separates yourself from the Medici Palace.
The first 10 windows in the southern part correspond to the original Medici Palace, while the remaining 7 are the result of subsequent intervention made by the Riccardi family during the 600. Here it is the entrance to the palace and the museum. The courtyard is made by 4 sides, each consists of 5 spans and stone columns. We find the shield with the symbol of the Medici family, 7 spheres arranged in a circle. There are many hypotheses about its meaning. The most accredited is that it's one of the most frequent figures of heraldry. The sphere symbolizes the studs of war shields. In 1465, Piero il Gottoso obtained from Louis XI, King of France, the privilege of being able to include the symbol of France in his coat of arms, a small shield with 3 golden lilies on the blue background. The courtyard was conceived as a space for ceremonies and celebrations, but also acted as a waiting room for those who went to the palace to have an audience with Lorenzo the Magnificent. In the 15th century, we could have admired the Donatello's David in the center of the courtyard. The tour of the palace starts from the monumental staircase that allows you to go up to the main floor and access one of the most beautiful places in the building, the Chapel of the Magi. The chapel was mainly a private church for the Medici family, and the room is dominated by the fresco by Benozzo Gozzoli, depicting the procession of the Magi. The youngest king, Gaspar, was associated with the figure of the young 13 years old Lorenzo Medici, already a promising young man of the Medici family, although it is much more likely that the young Lorenzo was portrayed in the procession that follows Gaspar together with his brother Giuliano. Here it's possible to admire the Carlo VIII room, named in the memory of the king's stay in 1494. The palace was built by the will of Cosimo the Elder. Cosimo entrusted the work to the architect Michelozzo di Bartolomeo. The works began in 1445. The building was owned by the Medici family until 1659, when Gabriello Riccardi bought the building from Ferdinando II Medici for 40,000 scudi. Since then, the palace was owned by the Riccardi family. The Luca Giordano Room was built between 1670 and 1677 at the behest of the Riccardi. The walls are adorned with gold, while the magnificent affresco of the ceiling dominates the room. The key, symbol of the Riccardi family, forms the center of the fresco, while on the sides the cardinal virtues fighting against vices are represented. The walled garden is the result of various interventions that took place over the centuries. So today we have no idea how the garden could have been in Lorenzo's time. Today we can admire the magnificent statues, as well as the two symbols of the Medici and Riccardi families, thus linked for eternity.